listen here. Oh, yeah. Oh, oh. We're here. We're doing it. I think it's happening.
Going live!
Yeah, we are. Yeah. Good. Test this out.
Testing the sound.
I'll do it. I'll do it real quick. You keep talking.
Testing the sound. Look at us now. We are testing the sound, and we're smoking cigars, using B-cuts, singing our song.
It's good. We're not singers.
Now, folks, if you haven't done so already, go ahead and hit that like button.
Sound is good. Hi, Derek Beckman. Do you know Derek?
Probably.
Okay. Who are you, Derek?
You got to tell us your handle. As we smoke some stogies given to us by the Florida Connection, the man.
Florida Sungrown.
Sam.
Yeah. I bet he pops in tonight. He's usually here. Oh, let's do this. Let's do this.
You do your thing. I got some cedar. I'm going to finish up talking to some folks. And if you're here with us, let us know you're here so we can give you a quick shout out. Yeah, we're just trying to gather some folk to join the conversation here with us this fine evening. And as always, we want to know what you're drinking, what you're smoking tonight.
Well, you know what we're smoking?
Florida Sungrown.
Man, that was shit. Oh, my. What?
Yeah?
Yeah, right away. That's a nice tobacco. You know anything about these?
No, I was hoping Tam would show up and tell us something.
He might. We'll get this StreamYard thing going next time, and we'll start having some guests on this show as we go. Oh, boy. Yeah, man, that is... That is nice. Just give it a little touchy do. Cleaning up a little bit. Cool. So if you're here already, let us know what you're smoking and drinking.
And since Ty moved in, I would say our cigar consumption has gone up tenfold.
Yeah, it's been dangerous and terrible for us, and we don't care. Mm-hmm. As my father would say, everybody's got to die, and we can't all go in cars. So,
wise man. Or
pretty,
something.
Pretty fart smeller, yeah.
Pretty fart smeller indeed.
Oh, I'm excited.
Yeah, so it's been cold last few days, so we figured we'd warm up with a little something here.
Has it ever been cold? I started a new job, and freezing my butt off, but not nearly as much as some of the other people around me that don't have the luxury of being inside heated cabs.
Yeah.
It was day four until I learned that my piece of equipment had a heated seat button.
Nice.
I'm spoiled.
Yeah, so we're smoking Florida Sungrown from our good friend Tam. And we're drinking Old Malt Cask.
Yes, Lefroy. 50% ABV, as they all are.
Yeah. As I recently found out, they're not.
They're not all 50?
Matthew Graham poured a dram for me the other day of Atushtashkik, or whatever it is.
That sounds
And it was cask strength.
60-something?
It was 56 or 54 point something. Damn. I was like, what the hell? Blew me away, but it was a brand new bottle.
So Old Malt Cask is 50 and above.
I always thought it was 50.
So I thought they always pulled it at exactly 50.
I just found out a couple days ago that is, I guess, something new maybe they're trying. But, like, I didn't know that, right?
Oh, well, yeah, we did this at Q. Hopefully you've seen that video. If you are lucky enough to live in Alberta and pre-COVID were able to visit Q, then you know what's going on. If you haven't, you can go for a quick little virtual tour and have a drink and a smoke with us while we drank this originally. Now, it was, did we open it there? I think we did.
Yeah.
We hunted this down. It was a fresh kill, and we saved it specifically for Q, and now we drink it with cigars. Mm. So Derek picked up a couple of new Glendronics and three new to me Anox the other day.
Which Glendronics?
Yes, which Glendronics? And Derek, you still have not told us who you are. We'd like to know. We'd like to know, you know, who's joining us on these lovely Sundays. It's been a damn shame not being able to do them regularly. And just not only am I drinking the Lefroy Old Malt Cask of Fine Cigars Pleasure, I have the very remnants left. You can see the color difference.
Oh, wow.
A Lefroy Cardias.
It's more like Cardias!
Yeah, that's how you say it in Scottish.
Unless it's French.
It might be. No, it said it was Gaelic. It said it was Gaelic.
Okay, cool. Then it was like, Cardias!
Whatever they say. But yeah, that is the Portwood.
One of my favorite Lefroy's to come through in years.
I'm going to say it's my favorite Lefroy.
I can see that.
Yeah, yeah. It was the first one that really opened up the peat for me. You guys can learn all about it in an upcoming episode. We haven't done any other Lefroy's, have we?
No. Sorry, I'm answering a bunch of people here.
Come on our show. Stop texting me.
Of Glendronic 2005, 14 year, 1928, 58, 2008, 12 year. Nice. Here's one on my handle. Yeah, Derek. We don't know who Derek Beckman is.
Yeah.
You know, we generally know most of these people from Instagram and things of that nature.
You posted up. Who's Jeff? Oh, that's Soupy.
Soupy, yeah.
Oh. See? I don't call him Jeff.
Soupy Sales.
It's like, who the fuck is Jeff?
How did you get here?
We'll have to send us some stuff. I'm on Instagram. Just my name also. Derek Beckman. All right, cool. So I don't think we actually know you, but that's cool. Maybe we'll meet sometime. Where do you live?
Checking it out right
What's
now.
What's your story? You're going to find him?
Give us your home address and your social security number.
Yeah, yeah. And we also need your mother's maiden name and your first pet's name.
Derek.
He says he follows Josh. He lives in Illinois. All right.
Ooh.
Makes sense.
Oh, there's many Derek Beckmans.
They follow you?
Is it Derek _ Beckman? And then it's a bunch of capital letters, Derek Beckman? No. No, that's definitely not it. My bad. I can't find Derek.
That's all right. We'll find him eventually.
We will.
He lives in Illinois. Who else is in Illinois? PW in there? Maybe he's in Michigan. I don't remember.
I don't know. Love Tiffany's Chicago, in Michigan. City, oh, he just messaged me. Oh, I'm following you also.
Oh, so it's making sense now.
Yes.
You don't follow a lot of people.
Yeah, I don't follow many people at all.
Wow.
That means you've made an impression on me?
Oh
yeah, cool. We
not
had a conversation.
For him to remember, though.
We had a conversation about spay fumer.
What you got to know is Josh also enjoys the wacky tobacco. So this affected his memory. And I've recently just started explaining to people that I'm like Alex Jones. I'm kind of retarded.
So. Seriously, hope he doesn't mind me showing. But he said it, so it's Glendronic's.
Okay, the, nice the 05s, is that what he said he got? The 05s?
2014, 2020.
2005.
Or 14-year-old 2020. PX cask, and Oloroso. I would probably lean more towards the Oloroso.
Does Costco sell alcohol in Alberta?
You bet your ass.
Yeah, it does. Not always the most wonderful of selection, but we have found some bangers there occasionally.
Cheap to cheap.
But now I'm seeing a bunch of people posting about the Kirkland Signature 23-year-old.
Mm.
And yeah. I think we should pick it up.
Good luck.
Yeah? Really?
Been, Yeah, that's a States bottle. Oh. We had the 25 here, and it was delicious, man. It was $140 for a 25-year-old Speyside, probably McKellen or Glen Parkless or something.
We don't get those often.
No, not yeah. very often now. You'll see the 12-year-old and the blend, the big-ass bottle blend, which I'm going to get. Super cool novelty. I think it'll be really hilarious to pour it and do a review of this big-ass bottle.
I'm down. Let's do it.
Yeah, nice bottles, Derek. Cool. Now I know who you are. We've chatted
before. We've put a face to the name.
Yeah, and I don't write anything down ever. Excuse me. So I'm happy that... I can see Instagram's conversations.
This is as nice as I remember it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I was just talking to Tam.
So, is the legend himself going to join us?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's good, man. I like that a lot. It's got a kind of sweetness as well. It's very interesting. Like a sweet pepperminty ting.
We have noticed that a lot of these peated whiskeys, when you pair with a cigar, really cut that peat down and open up a bunch of different flavors.
I'm not getting a hell of a lot of smoke output. I would prefer much more, but I really enjoy the flavor of this. It's got a sweet kind of
nuttiness. Oh, right off the bat, yeah. Right off the initial light. There he is. He's here now.
The Florida connection.
The man himself.
We're smoking the ones that you put in there. As far as I know.
Well, I mean, it's from Florida. Does anybody else live in Florida that matters?
Oh, I'm repping there.
Well, Scotch Test Dummies.
Yeah, someone gave me this shirt. Oh, Maniacs. Oh, love the beat. Love the beat.
I'm repping Dick's Out for Harambe. It's a cause I believe in. He died for your sins. He took a shot, so let's take a shot.
Cheers, Harambe. My dick's been out for Harambe since 2016.
It's getting cold and chilly. You got you a bad stogie. No, absolutely not. No, we're actually really enjoying this. Right off the hop, the tobacco on this, I don't know what it is, had a touch of sweetness, but it's just lovely. It's a very well-balanced cigar. I don't know anything about it.
That sweetness was undeniable, too.
Yeah. Like, almost like it was like a dip, like an
infused cigar. Yeah, right away.
Yeah.
It was very weird. It's gone now. But, I'm enjoying it quite a bit. I just said it's not a hell of a lot of smoke output, but it's still quite nice and flavorful.
You can do it a bit. Maybe you got the bad batch today.
Yeah, but I think that...
it might just be your lighting.
This will be very simple for me to fix.
Oh, 100%.
In just a second here. I'm just going to let it take its toll for a minute. And actually, it's a learning opportunity.
So this is funny because
I'm smoking fast too, right?
The last few picks, I've picked one that has done that. And I was starting to think it was me.
And we had a conversation today too.
Yeah. And so like I have not had this issue. Mine's pretty consistent.
I do believe this will fix itself. It might need just a little bit of coaxing. And if that happens, I'll show you what we do.
Florida sun-grown wraps have this nice funk to them. It's a twang.
Mm.
It's a twang. A little Florida twang. It's nice, though. Can't do that. I don't have those skills.
I often get people compliment me on my O's. I really enjoy that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I get that.
But, man, this pairs with a cigar, like, tremendously. That's probably why there's not much left. Like I said, since Ty moved in, well, we've been enjoying a fine cigar's pleasure, and that's an understatement.
Give me your O face, Josh.
Damn straight, man.
Yep, that just happened. Oh, yeah. Derek said he's pouring a dram of Nika Yoichi. Yoichi? I'm not familiar with that particular bottle of Nika.
Which one?
Yoichi? Y-O-I-C-H-I.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, let's pull it up.
Yeah. Give me a little looksy poo.
Pretty standard Nika style box.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I can get behind that because I've enjoyed a lot of great Japanese whiskeys, and we have been stockpiling quite a few.
Yeah. This Nika spring. Does it right too.
Yeah, they're delicious. Not one of those ones that's using Canadian whiskey.
Touche.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That we know of.
That we know of. That we know of. Yeah. So we're gonna do what I like to call just a little coaxing,
a little touchy uppy.
Yeah, just up around the.
What happened there?
I don't know. Just up around the longest edge. Interesting. I'm going to light it right there. Just to coax it around, and I'm going to come around. Some people will tell you not to do this, and I usually tell them to go fuck themselves.
That Yoichi's peated.
Yeah, oh. All the way around. How'd you know that?
Because Derek just said so.
Oh. Yeah.
I'm getting fed some inside information from someone drinking it as we speak.
Yeah, so I'm just heating up the whole way around here, letting it catch up. And what a lot of people don't do is light the other end, too. And we'll see if that would make a little bit of a difference. I think it would.
It's a lovely pairing, though.
Mm-hmm.
So, Tam, can you give us any information on Florida Sungrown?
Yeah, what is this?
Is that the name of the company? Is this all they make? Is just this one stick? Where in Florida is it actually Floridian tobacco? What's the deal, bro?
My stogie did that right at the halfway point today. Let the cigar die down a bit and torch it while purging.
Yeah, that's a good way to do it. Nom nom nom. Nom nom nom. Switch over to the port.
Alrighty. Yeah. That Nika I find to be a touch like earthy, kind of herbaceous.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit salty kind of peeps.
I don't think I've seen it on the shelves here.
I don't know. I can't even remember where I've had it for some reason. It just, I don't know how it sticks in there. But
no one knows how your brain works.
It does, man.
It's a beautiful mind. From Clement, Florida. Florida Sungrown was also used in that Army of Angels and the Tampa FSG Davidoff.
Oh.
Hmm. All right.
Interesting. Now, folks, if you haven't done so already, go ahead and like this video.
from kicking
the algorithm.
We like to see the likes match the people viewing. Mm-hmm. We like the numbers to be even. It's an OCD thing.
Mm-hmm.
That was my neck. I don't know if you could hear that. That happened. That's the thing that happened. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm going to let that cigar burn and mellow for a bit.
It's kind of a really nice white ash, too. It's good, if I remember correctly, good ammonia concentrate in the soil. I could have also just pulled that entire thing out of my asshole. So, let me know if I'm wrong. I don't know. I like learning.
Learning is great because knowledge is power.
Yeah. Also, knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joke Stream!
Dolls for boys! So, it's an FSG filler. Nicaraguan, Honduran blender, and Brazil. Interesting. So the wrapper is actually grown in Florida. Okay. And then just a weird blend, Nicaraguan, Honduran. Nice. Yeah. No. Sorry, what did he say? A Brazilian Arapirica Maduro wrapper.
Alpaca?
So what's Florida Sungrown is just the name. Yeah, okay. I did zero research He said, pick one. And I picked this. And that's the extent of it. I lit it up. And right away, I was interesting flavor off the bat.
Oh, the filler is Florida Sun Grown. Okay. Okay.
Can't get into cigars, man. You know, it's not for everybody. I don't smoke cigarettes. I smoked half a pack once in high school because I thought it was cool. But someone introduced me to cigars, and man, I'm a fan. It's just like whiskey. You got to try a bunch of different ones, find out what you like. Everyone's got a go-to at this point, but not us. We pretty much run the gamut. I mean, like
everything.
We got two big desktop humidors going right now, and there's probably 70 different types of cigars in there. So it's a matter of taste, man. I mean, if you had never had whiskey and they gave you this Lafroy as your first whiskey and this was your impression of what whiskey is, probably wouldn't like it.
One of two things. You're going to instantly love it or you're going to hate it for years.
And then you have in your mind that that's what whiskey tastes like. Yeah. It's probably the same for cigars. If you can remember what it was that you tried for a cigar that made you go, ooh, that's not for me, we could probably recommend something that's opposite and different.
Yeah, I'm pretty confident. I know you would be able to. No doubt.
Not so much anymore. I mean, like,
I started smoking cigarettes when I was 12, and I smoked till I was like 26, 27, and I smoked Prime Times, those little cigarillos, for years. I was two packs a day in college of Du Maurier King Size, and I smoked Export A Silver towards the end of it, and I'm telling you right now, I've been quit for years. Oh, it's just this close, though. Yeah. Any given time, man, I could just fucking start smoking. I loved it, and I miss it, and I love it.
Well, we're already getting a massive amount of nicotine intake just from our cigar usage.
Yeah, but so. I used to smoke cigars as well, and, like, cigarettes, too. Yeah. I smoked for a while.
Well, he poked a lot of smut in high school. I read that. I didn't say it, but well done. I became a paramedic a few years out of high school, so I had to quit. Love the smell of cigars, but can't smoke them. It's been so long since I've had one. Okay, fair enough. I'll leave that to Josh because he is the poker of smot here in the Whiskey Heathens.
Yeah.
Isn't there one out there called Nug that's got, like, it's a cigar with CBD in it?
Oh, you can get cannabis cigars now.
Yeah, I know, but that's not what I mean.
Oh, I'm not sure. Maybe.
I don't know if there's an appeal to it or something. I saw something on it briefly while perusing the internets.
Well, either.
The net of webs of inner.
Something's going on.
Yeah.
That's all we know.
If you stick around long enough, I mean, you'll find out that we've got a lot of fans that enjoy cigars. You just got to try some more, really. I mean, if you like the smell of it.
I tell everybody to go buy an Acid Blonde.
Yeah, so snobs are going to shit on that.
Let them shit down my fucking throat, man. Whatever. I don't even care.
The Acid Blondes, they're an infused cigar. They're sweet to the touch, or sweet to the taste, I should say.
Sweet to the touch of the lips.
Oh, yeah. I love stroking a blonde. Mm-hmm. It's a good introductory cigar. They're the ones that turned my girlfriend's opinion on cigars around. Yeah.
I got to tell you something right now. I enjoy smoking a cigar. I enjoy the social aspect of it. I enjoy the flavors.
The ritualistic.
Yeah, it is. It's ritualistic. Exactly, right? That's why I toast the top with cedar, because I fucking can. Like, it's fun, you know? Yeah, so enjoyable. People who say, I don't smoke acid. Like, no. Same people that saying I don't drink anything with single malt, right?
Yeah, it's just snobby.
Let them limit themselves. And at the end of the day, if that's not what they like, fine. Don't like it. But don't shit on other people for liking it, man.
Who I like Gurkhas.
I don't want Gurkhas.
Yeah. I mean.
Too bad we couldn't flash hashtag unpopular opinion. Right?
Yeah, we can't really add anything to this. Maybe we could.
Gurkhas are the McKellen of the cigars right now. It's very trendy to hate on them. McKellen makes some good whiskey, but they're few and far between. At this point, Gurkha seems to be few and far between. And for ourselves, wasn't it one that we didn't enjoy?
I'm trying to think of which one, because we had the Beauty, the Beast. We've had
several.
Fuck, we've had a ton. I ended up buying multiple sample packs and tried a bunch. But yeah, the Acid Blonde, it is a flavored cigar, but it's a good way to get you into the whole aspect of it. This for me, you know what this is? When I'm alone, obviously not live and hanging out with Josh, but when I'm alone and I smoke a cigar, that's my form of prayer. That's my meditation.
Mm-hmm.
That right there represents to me at least an hour, sometimes 2 hours, for me to just be alone with my thoughts. It's a great way to relax. Yep. You also get an influx of nicotine. Classic writer's block solution was cigarettes and coffee, but that's because nicotine and caffeine are creative stimulants. So it helps get those brain juices flowing, and it just feels good.
Yep.
You can get quite a buzz off a good cigar.
Yeah, so
a huge influx of nicotine.
Those of you who are watching, be careful. Do not smoke too fast. I'm a fast smoker.
You are,
but I've been smoking fast for a lot of years.
Yeah, and if you're not used to it, you'll green out real quick.
You will likely green out if you have a big fatty.
You get nicotine poisoning. It's happened to me a few times.
Me too. Have a nice meal before, and that's what it's all about. Who's this guy?
That is my best friend from childhood.
Oh.
That
sell your whiskey and buy GME.
Stonks. Are you following this whole GameStop thing?
Yeah, man. Isn't that crazy?
I spent hours trying to figure out, like, my stupid little brain couldn't figure out what shorts and short squeezing are, and I did a bunch of research, and I think I got a grasp on it.
I do too, man.
I don't gamble anymore, dude. I had a gambling problem when I went to university.
They bet on stocks to do bad so they can give them back and buy them back.
Right? Yeah. So one thing I don't get is like, oh, we're borrowing the stock. Like, who are you borrowing it from? Who are you borrowing it
from? That's the thing. Who's just
gonna lend it to you? I don't get it. So that's
it's literally gambling, man.
No, 100%.
It's betting.
So a bunch of weaponized autistic kids on Reddit were able to take down a hedge fund just by like, no, I'm going to treat it like a casino.
They start buying shares. So then for the company to buy them back, they need to buy them at higher instead of lower now, as they predicted. Them back at higher, which drives the price up again.
The only part of it I don't get.
And it just keeps going up and up and up and up.
Is who are you borrowing it from, though?
Them.
You borrow it from yourself?
Big Brother owns them.
I don't know. But yeah, definitely not going to be selling my whiskey to buy stocks. I'll buy stock and whiskey, physical bottles I can hold.
Trying to explain my mustache and I sold all the scotch.
Five times leverage equals five times the yachts. Yeah, I don't need a yacht. I live in landlocked province.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh. I haven't talked to Ryan in a while. Oh, man. In my office, I have multiple boxes with shipping labels on them that I just have not gone to the fucking post office. And I got one for him. And I told them I'd send it months ago, and I never did. I'm scatterbrained. It will come to you soon. There will be a day where I'm like, oh, I got to clear some space. Might as well go to the post office.
One of these days, and that day may never come, I will call upon you not to do a favor for me, but to receive my package.
Gross. Don't say it like that.
Hey, man. I stick by my story. Hmm. Remember? Half-baked. Samson, I stick by my story.
Right near the beach. I know Ryan's not smoking a cigar, but what are you drinking tonight,
guys? Hell yeah, man.
What are you drinking on? Dry February.
Mm.
Oh, well, that's sad.
We're at the Whiskey Heathens World Headquarters. There will be no dry February.
Ryan's never joined us before, so he's like, oh yeah, we won't be doing dry February. Alberta's pushing it hard, though. I got sponsored ads from the government of Alberta pushing for dry February on Instagram and Facebook. And they're like, well, why don't you just not drink alcohol? And I'm like, why don't you just fuck off?
Yeah. Why don't you suck my scrotum, Alberta government?
Yeah, stretch it out in this cold weather. Not good for you, man. I get that. I mean, it's almost over a year since you've had cigarettes, right? So that's pretty good. I mean,
nice.
He wouldn't smoke a cigar with me the last time I met up with him. because, you know, he just quit cigarettes. And it's a gateway drug to cigarettes. So I get that.
Except if you inhale cigars, you will die.
Yeah. Essentially. I mean, I'm not going to. I'm aging my scotch 28 days.
Okay, you're going to definitely have to explain yourself.
Yeah. What are you doing with it? Did you put it in like a special mini barrel, or you just open up the bottle and you let it sit so it evaporates and it's all gone and all that's left is sediment? Or what are you doing? Or you just mean you're just letting it sit for an extra 28 days before you drink it?
Yeah, because that's not aging. Let's get serious here.
Actually, this is fun. His father, Lorne, the first time I ever had scotch, he showed us, brought a glass out, and he brought another glass of water, and he dipped his pinky in the glass, a couple of drops in mm-hmm. just to open it up, and he explained it all to us. And I remember sitting in, not sitting, we were standing in his kitchen. The table was back there. We're standing in the kitchen. That's when he did it. I don't remember what the whiskey was. I don't remember what the scotch was. Do you remember, Ryan?
You remember the ritual, though.
I remember the ritual. It was the first time I'd ever seen it done.
Cool.
That's cool. It was a good lesson.
Yeah. That's super cool.
I think it was the same day we discussed if you put boiling water into ice cube trays, would it make a difference on how fast it would freeze compared to regular water? Or would it just make the ice cubes more clear?
They did that on Mythbusters.
Well, this was a conversation that happened at least 15 years ago. So maybe more. Man, Tam, this is still holding, bud.
Yeah, mine has come around.
Away from the computer.
Mine has come around.
Yeah, that's a beautiful ash.
It's beautiful smoke.
Nice and white.
The first one third was very flavorful, but problematic. Now I'm into about the last 50%, and it's been quite nice.
Yeah, man, you are such a fast smoker.
Yep.
Most likely a Glenfiddich or Laphroaig. So I can almost guarantee it wasn't a Laphroaig because that would have turned me off a whiskey. Yeah. Today we are drinking Laphroaig Old Malt Cask, a fine cigar's pleasure. And I am finishing what's remnants of a bottle kill of Laphroaig's 2020 Port and Red Wine Baroque finish.
So, one of the best to come through for that line in years.
Yeah, it was one of my top 10 whiskeys of the year for 2020, for sure.
Well, didn't I call that Pete at Whiskey of the Year? I think I did.
I don't recall. You've had so many posts since then. That's so 2020.
I thought I did. I'm going to check here now.
The new Cardis. No. Well, yeah, it was the 2020 Cardis. So
yeah. It is a new one, yeah.
Yeah. If anyone knows how to say that, Cardis, if you could spell it out phonetically, and then I'll read it that way, but we don't really know. But yeah, Ryan, it was probably Glenfiddich. Glenfiddich, we did recently. It hasn't been uploaded yet, but we're doing a whole side-by-side comparison of basic Glenfiddich and Glenlivet and individual episodes on those. But that was one of the first times I ever had scotch. I do remember that. I just don't remember what it was. And now, for anything over usually 50%, I'm adding water.
I always like to add water just to see.
Carchus. Figured out how to invite guests in, you heathen. Yeah, we did if we had started this with StreamYard. Straight YouTube again today, Dan. Sorry about that, buddy.
Well, I'd like to set this up, though, Dan.
Private message me this week after 7:30 at night when I get home and help me figure it out. And you and I could do a test, and then we can get this set up for a future Sunday evening to get this done. Doesn't feel like it, Josh. Yeah.
Fuck you, Dan. I did name it Whiskey of the Year. For
you did?
Yeah, top ranked for peated Whiskey of the Year.
For peated Whiskey of the Year?
Yeah.
Well.
But, oh, okay.
Did the black beat it out?
So it occurs to me the initial sweetness from the stogie was probably from my humidor. Spanish cedar sat a month before I shipped it out.
You know what? I'm okay with runner up. This one was runner up.
The Ardbeg Black Committee release.
Yeah. Upon further review, I explain myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you'll have to check his Instagram.
Yep.
And scroll back to find out more on that.
But yeah.
But for me, this was a top 10 whiskey of the year.
That's the one that got Pete at whiskey of the year for me. Deanston won distillery release whiskey of the year.
With the Olorosa 2002, yeah.
Mortlock won independent bottler whiskey of the year.
Yeah.
Lefroy won Pete at whiskey of the year.
I'm okay with all of that.
Yeah, that's pretty much the only ones I do. I do blend at whiskey of the year as well, which was the 17-year-old sherry from the whiskey agency.
Well, as of now, I know what my new favorite blend is. My favorite sherry and whiskey. As of today, it has changed.
Oh, shit. That was gooder.
Have you had the Ben Romick Bordeaux cask? I have not.
That's relatively new, right?
Tam, look at this. Look at it hold.
Dan. We got out of control that night, man. Shit. We went live with the fucking Scotch Test dummies. We were live with Food Quig, ordering from Joma's. Donairs and deep fried everything.
Bowling alley wasn't open then.
No, this is years ago. And our shirts were off. Oh, God, what a disaster. People messaged us, were like, you guys need some help. You need to stop drinking and stuff.
Get fucked. How about that?
And I was like, hey, partner, don't you worry about my health.
You don't tell me what to do. No.
This is like really starting to shine. I thought it was.
I'm going to see what happens when this ash falls off. It's going to open up a bit.
Oh, for sure. I'm going to purge mine now.
Yeah. Holy shit. A lot of ammonia in that. Ammonia. Wow. Smoker's lungs for sure. How'd that feel?
I think I'm going to try one more time.
I'm tempted to just knock this ash off just so I can do that. Weird. It's got a weird shape. Heavy on the top, itty bitty waist going back into a big butt. It's like a Niece Wadehofer out of Texas. Sure, it's not just Josh's breath making that. It might be. I mean, there's been quite a bit of alcohol consumed today.
Dan, I know. Yeah, people were legit concerned, like, about our well-being, man.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like, you guys are committing a crime on live television type thing?
Who?
I don't know. What are they telling you? Just because you were drinking so much?
Me and Dan?
Yeah.
That's not a crime.
I know it's not a crime. I'm saying, is that why they were concerned, though?
They were concerned that we were just hammered and taking our clothes off and eating deep fried fruit sloppily.
That sounds wonderful.
That was wonderful.
It sounds like a Tuesday.
It was a 4-hour, 5-hour just session of buds chatting, getting drunk together.
We're going to do that this summer. Yeah. I think what we're going to end up doing is some campfire sessions in the Zen garden, going live with the fire. That'll be nice.
Yep, I'm ready for that.
I'm ready for it, too. This minus 28 degree mornings can fuck off.
Yeah, it's been chilly, man.
Oh, yeah. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
Yeah, this is quite nice. I like this a lot.
Well, enough reminiscent bullshit. What are you drinking tonight, Dan? What do you got in your glass?
Anyone who's watching, what are you drinking? What have you been drinking?
You
Yeah, you know what? I can't argue. I get it. That's cool, dude. No worries. Thanks for joining us. I'd like to chat with you on the phone here soon. It's been too long, my friend. But yeah, thanks for popping in. I know it's probably late. What is it, like 9:30 something?
Put us on in the background to soothe your dogs while you're away.
No animals for him.
Okay, I'll just go fuck myself.
Yeah, there you go. Thanks, Ryan. I'll give you a text later on this week, buddy. We'll schedule maybe our own little private Skype session because I miss you, dude. Enjoy watching 90 Day Fiancé. I got wings in the oven. That's not a drink, Dan. Well, I mean, you could drink the
You could technically juices drink wings. Left. You got a powerful blender.
Ooh, blended wings.
Oh, I didn't say it would be good.
It might be, though.
I doubt it.
Well, you got to take the meat off the bones, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Going through Ardbeg today. Beastie, an OA, 10, wrapping it up with an Oogie. Whiskey sour. Oogie whiskey sour sounds pretty fucking good.
I could get into that. I'm also very curious your thoughts on the wee beastie.
Yeah, I've not had it yet.
Oh, I loved it.
Did you?
Yeah.
I heard it was
a lot of people said it
was very young.
Good. Yeah, people said it wasn't good.
No?
And I disagree.
We do an episode soon?
If I can fucking find any.
It's gone, eh?
Gone, man. It's a regular release now, but it's in batches. So
I'm trying to hook you up with some beer guys in the U.S. I just got some amazing beers from Duclaw. Pretty excited. Those of you that are watching, if you're unaware, I not only do I drink whiskey and smoke cigars at night, but I drink beer every morning in the shower. Quick 1 minute shower beer reviews. So if you know some interesting beers and you're interested in sending me some from your hometowns, let me explore outside of the beautiful province of Alberta. Please message me on Instagram or Facebook, or if you have my phone number. Or
do not send beer in the winter in Alberta.
Yeah, that's true too.
Yeah, I've learned from past experience.
Yeah,
that they explode violently. Yeah,
that's not all he does in the shower. You're correct. I also wash my asshole, shampoo my hair, which usually consists of my whole body because I'm a beast.
The master chef himself has just signed in as well.
Drinking Kilchloman PX single cask.
It's probably a pretty lovely whiskey.
Our go-to Kilchloman expert, Sean Kincaid, is not here today.
Not here.
Still trying to convince him. He works at the site beside me. There's no reason he couldn't come to town one night.
I agree.
Yeah. It's a personal choice of his.
Yeah, but I think he gets paid like for the whole flying thing too, right?
Yeah, but he could still check out a camp for like a run or whatever.
Yeah, I'm talking last day when I'm off. I could go out and get him and he could crash and then take the sniper trail home.
Yeah.
He's got to coordinate.
He's not even here. We're talking about him. So should wash out the mouth.
Back up to Ardbeg.
Okay.
Wee Beastie is young and brash, says Tam, and I agree. And then Derek said people tastes young. It depends on people's definition of young. To me, young is a youthful, zesty kind of vibrant thing that happens. And people will sometimes call young spirity. And I don't associate youth with spirity necessarily. Okay. I associate youth with the menthol and eucalyptus type of thing.
The new make type.
Yeah.
Okay.
Spirity to me is Gibson's. You know what I mean? It's harsh and intense and it's like young corn type of thing.
Okay.
That's what I think a lot of people associate young with. And that's just not the case for me. And it's just from conversations I've had with others. I'm not sure how you feel about it. But does it taste young? Yes. And it pairs well with the peat. To me, it's very bright and very refreshing.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's like a very refreshing, bright, youthful dram.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good. I like it.
I look forward to trying it. Peat, obviously.
So. Yeah, I would absolutely have a bottle here. I would 100%. And it's not that far off the 10-year-old when it comes to price. And that's what got people up in arms.
How much was it?
It was $70
for a 5-year Ardbeg.
Here it is. See, 5 years.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
Oh,
But this is the notion, and this is why people don't put age statements on their young whiskeys, because people are terrified.
Right? Yeah, Five years, man. I get it.
I do too, but I liked it.
I like Tam's description here. He says, you know, you have angry driving music. We Beastie is angry drinking scotch. We don't encourage drinking and driving. However, I understand what you're saying. BBC is a teenage full of angst, amusing and great to have around, but young and no real depth. What a description.
I couldn't agree more.
What a description. WeBC is just sitting in the corner playing on his phone.
I could not agree more. Man, you hit the nail on the head, partner.
My only issue with it was the finish was on the thin side. It climbs full of forward flavors, but as soon as it hits the top of your palate, it kind of disappears.
Sure. It's a young... Okay. Semi-mass produced whiskey. There's no complex cask. You know what I mean? It's not like your Glentocher's 4-year-old from Carmore. And it's not meant to be that.
That would be the youngest peated whiskey I've ever had. So I'm interested just to see what youthfulness and peat bring together.
I drank the Beast as it poured out of the stills and it was still warm.
Oh, you're here in Fort Murray, not Wee Beastie, but the Beast.
The Beast, yeah, which is peated.
Mm, interesting.
It was very interesting.
Had it side by side with a 2020 Oogie, and the Beastie was better.
Oh, we had this conversation. Shocked me. Shocked me enough to seek out a bottle of 2020. Because what we got around here is not 2020. It's several years old, and it's been sitting on the shelves, and you can still get it at the liquor stores, and it's fucking delicious.
Yeah?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oogie for what price, though? It's
$88.
That was one of those over like $200. Nope. What am I thinking?
Well, in Ontario, it's $190.
So it's half price here in Alberta. Yes.
Now, sometimes it goes up to $120. I've seen it. But most of the time, it's hovering around $90. You're $95 all in. It's delicious. It's great. I haven't had the 2020. So far, people are saying the 2020 is very abrasive and not refined, so I really need to try it and seek it out. Because the real old stuff, excuse me, has older malt in there as well. The real old stuff before 2007. But this stuff's like 2012. Okay. That's around here. Good stuff. 2020, I'm coming for you. And the master chef told me it's not good. So he has a palate that... He understands what he likes and what he does not like.
And chefs have a different palate when it comes to this stuff.
So I'm telling you, if he doesn't like it, it makes me want to try it. Because sometimes trying something that's bad is just as exciting as trying something that's really good. You know? Because then you fucking know and you can tell everybody.
What about the new Ardbegs, the 25 and the Mickey Heads? I don't even know what you're talking about.
I'm not going to go spend over $1,000.
Oh, what?
For Ardbeg 25. Not happening, man. It's not happening. If someone sends me a sample, I'll go in on a bottle. Gladly go in on a bottle purchase with people. No problem at all just to get to try it. But I'm not buying that. Man. That's ridiculous.
$1,000, I can think of so
many other things. Oh, it's well over $1,000, dude.
Oh.
Yeah.
The 25.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. No.
Tam has the 2018 Oogies. I can't remember the last one I had, but I've loved every Oogie that I've had. So I really got to try this new stuff because new Glendronach 12 is like laughable compared to old Glendronach 12. But old Glendronach 12 has old casks.
That's right.
It's so it's older 18, whiskey. Right?
Or 16, whatever it is.
We got spoiled when we were coming into the game because there was Glendronach and shit like that around at the time, right?
I'm going to do something just because I really want to see the flavor profile change. But I got to say, Tam, that ash is held on fucking beautifully, man.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, wow. Nice clean break.
Yeah. That's gooder. That's a winner, man.
Pass that lighter over. Maybe just a little purge.
Oh, after purge, that's going to be perfect. Mine has come around.
Yep.
I don't mind the Perpetuum. I don't mind any Ardbeg. Ardbog is my favorite Ardbeg. I have one left, man. And Now to buy them, they're $450, $500.
My favorite art
can't do that.
And I only had it once, was the Supernova
mm.
that Lady Whiskey Z poured for us when we did a Crasher Stash. Only because I had not had a ton of art bag. It's been said before, Derek, it sounds like you're kind of one of our newer fans. Obviously a fan of Josh, but the Whiskey Heathens. Ardbeg has been one of those whiskeys that I have been reaching for while editing. I usually try when I'm editing up our episodes to drink what I'm editing. It doesn't make a difference. It's just, it's a nice feeling to remember while I'm, you know, doing it. But when I'm done, whatever that happens to be, I reach for an Ardbeg.
It's ritualistic, man.
Just reach for an Ardbeg 10. It just, it's something that's always just comforting and delicious yeah. and good price. And
those of you who are, long time, I don't know if I guess fan is the right word, but
supporters
of Heathens. Know Your Whiskey. I used to drink Ardbeg 10 back when I hosted Tipsy Trivia. That was my bar dram until eventually they stopped ordering it and I drank all of it because drinks were free. So they were like, man, these Ardbegs are just disappearing. I was like, whatever, man. You're pouring me hard bags. I'm going to drink them, right?
I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah. So then I moved to Laphroaig's. I used to drink Laphroaig 10s down there.
What bar was that at?
Wood Buffalo Brewhouse.
Okay. Yeah. I look forward to going in there when some of these restrictions lift. Restaurants are opening up again here soon, apparently.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're in stage 4 or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Okay. Good, so man. I don't want to talk about that garbage.
Good.
Whiskey gets the mental juices flowing. That's real talk.
Nick says Dark Cove. Everybody stop.
Bitch, I wish you would burn my motherfucking clothes. Real talk. That's an R. Kelly thing. Never mind.
Wow.
If you got time later on.
Check out Ty's R. Kelly trivia show.
Bitch, I wish you would burn my motherfucking clothes. Real talk. I'm the white Tyrese.
I could just see our followers just dropping on.
Hey, 5 people left. Huh? That's weird. What happened?
I don't remember what I was going to say.
It's because you're racist and you don't like R. Kelly? Or is it just because he pisses on kids? Whatever. Keep throwing out bangers and piss on as many people as you want. It's a free pass, I think.
Music here at the Whiskey beer. Heathens, we do not condone peeing on children.
Unless it's from heights.
Unless it's accidental and agreed, usually.
You're on the 18th floor of an apartment complex and there's some kids playing down there.
How do we get a thumbs down? Have you seen our show?
Do we have a thumbs down? We can only see thumbs up.
That's how we get a thumbs down, by being us, by being boorish and
real.
Fucking, yeah, just rambunctious.
Here's the problem. Thumbs down generate because a thought happens and then it just comes out.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Now,
we're real
do we apologize? No. No, we don't.
I learned that from some older comedians that taught me that you just don't apologize. The moment you apologize, they win and they can turn it into a whole thing. And you're like, I'm sorry. What I said was insensitive to such and such community, and I've learned a lot from this past experience. That's all horseshit. Every time they do that, it's fake. It's what their PR and their agent and their management told them they had to do as a redemption factor. They don't mean it, and it doesn't actually do anything. It just lets someone else on the internet go, yeah, we got him. We made him apologize. We win. So we don't do stories.
You know, looking back on tonight's conversation, when you think about it, the thumbs down probably came around the point when we started talking about peeing on children.
This possibility. It was more than likely. I said what I said. There's always a hater out there. You know what it is? It's a kid that got peed on that grew up and is upset about it. I get it. But one of my favorite hobbies is drinking whiskey and pushing kids off bikes. You should try it sometime. Go to the park, you know. Police might get called, but just leave before they get there.
Just mortified.
This is your fault. I don't know how, but it is.
You're the one singing R. Kelly. I'm here for the Pete, baby.
It's an inside joke with a few people that actually know that song. So when someone says "Real Talk," my response is, "Bitch, I wish you would burn my motherfucking clothes."
Do they watch our program?
Probably not.
Oh, no, it's too bad.
No, I got friends in circles that don't give a fuck about us. My own friends won't support me in half the shit I do. That's okay, though. Heathens keeping it real. That's right. I want to pull this up. I want to show you so you don't think I'm an absolute fucking moron. So you understand what I'm talking about. I'm going to find it. I'll find it.
Are you playing R. Kelly?
I'm going to.
Not my top 10 choices for music.
I don't blame you. It's okay. It doesn't have to be. You carry on. I'm going to find this.
Yeah. So Master Chef, Nick, what are you drinking tonight? Who else joined us? Clayton, what are you drinking? Everybody who hasn't told us, even if you have, what are you drinking tonight? I want to know.
I'm going to find this. Don't worry. I know you weren't worried, but still.
Tamdu 15. Great choice. What are your thoughts? Is it rich enough for you? Still drinking the Nika?
No man having assholes.
Well, I haven't poured anything yet. The night is young, sir. You find it?
I'm just waiting for it to come to that exact point so people know what I'm talking about.
Hopefully we don't get a copyright claim.
We won't. It's live.
Is it?
Yeah. And it's only going to be a brief second.
Good. Fucking YouTube, man. It's like they don't want us to post videos. Like, fuck.
They don't, because we don't do children's shows. That's where they make their money.
Children's shows, eh? We do shows literally about debauchery.
What now?
What?
What?
I'm just lost in the R. Kelly, man.
I know, it's good.
Well, it's not mine. I wouldn't say good. It's something. Yeah, fucking right. See, we can get R. Kelly. Nick, I got a fella who's going to pick up that bottle for you. I went to grab something for Nick, and I was quite drunk when I was there, and I picked up the complete wrong bottle. And he's like, sorry, man, maybe I wasn't clear, but, like, that's not what I wanted, eh? I was like, shit, my bad. I just scrolled up sober, looked at the text. I was like, fuck, this is not even close to what he wanted. And that was that Glen Ross.
Oh, the reserve one?
No, it was a young Carmore.
Okay.
And it was only cheap, so I was like, fuck it, man, I'm going to drink this because Glen Ross is usually shitty and tastes like a wet dog.
I'm not a fan.
Yeah, so maybe – everybody loves it, though. Everybody loves Glen Ross except me and Ty, man.
They're lying.
And I'm actually super excited to try this one and see if it redeems Glen Ross at all.
Okay, I got this for you. We'll bring this up. So in the future, you guys can get in on this inside joke. When someone says to you real talk, you can respond like this. You're already doing that shit anyway. You gonna burn what? Bitch, I wish you would burn my motherfucking clothes with your trifling ass, Milton. You bogus girl, Milton. Dodge your mom, warm it up, and get ready to take me home. Oh, I just love it. I just love it.
My motherfucking clothes.
Real tall. Yeah, you can check it out on your own time. It's classic. I love it. And it's my go-to response.
There it is.
So there you go. You can do it too. When someone says, what are you talking about? You'd be like, you wouldn't get it.
Yeah.
Hey, all our people left. What happened?
R. Kelly comes on. Fucking yeah. Follower count just drops.
Real talk, Milton.
He's stepping in the name of love. I mean, old school R. Kelly fan, man. I can't help it. People still like Michael Jackson, so you know what it is.
Real talk.
None of my business.
Oh, okay. Anyway, back to whiskey.
Yeah, so.
that was fun.
Now that everyone's gone, does anybody have a favorite whiskey that they're into recently? Is there anything that just really does it for you lately? I think I'm going to have to purge this, too.
You might have to. I can barely see the other side of the room.
Yeah, it's pretty foggy.
Do it.
It's going to get pretty chilly.
It's going to get cold and loud for a minute, folks.
I have the heater turned off, so. Oh, yeah.
Look, it just leaves like a giant smoke excess. Okay.
Glenmorangie, a star. There's two A Stars, right? A star lately. There's one from like 2009 or something, and there's another one from 2017. Is that the one I'm thinking about?
I have no idea.
I think it's the 2017, yeah. The 2017 was not as good as the other one. However, the other one was so friggin' good that it's really hard to live up to. And that 2017 is quite lovely. I enjoyed it.
And it tastes impossible old to find.
Yeah. It tastes old to me. It tastes older than it is. And I enjoyed it quite a bit, actually. Yeah. That's a little better, eh?
Oh, I can see the poster now.
Oh, still towering. Oh, look.
One day,
it's not even that cold.
We'll turn the camera so you can see. But it's literally just a billow of smoke rolls.
Oh, it's only minus 13.
Well, that's not bad. We can still chill out here in t-shirts.
I've got my shorts on.
See if my armpits are smoking. Nope. But that's my breath. Look. That's smoke, and that's my
breath. We're like dragons. Oh, Ecuador.
Oh. Oh.
Fuck yeah.
Actually, the Belichin, is that the one we had with Sean?
I can't remember, but it's peated and it's thick rubber, man.
Yeah, okay, that's the one. We have an Ecuador episode coming out.
Was it in a little box straight from the cask, like where we had to take it out of the wooden box?
It was like a blue box or something?
Yeah, a little tiny stubby bottle.
Yeah, yeah, something like that. Yeah,
buddy, do it.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Ecuador is fucking awesome. If you can find the fairy flag, you might be able to find it still in BC. Let me know right away. Fairy flag is my favorite Ecuador. It's 15-year-old. I think it's 46%. And my God, what an amazing whiskey that is. Any of their straight from the cask stuff is usually very young and abrasive whiskeys that I enjoy. And the Belichin is straight up melted rubber tires, man.
Ooh, okay, I'm down.
Do it.
Gonna be kind of like this Laphroaig.
Heavy, no, even more intense, man. Ooh. Heavy, intense rubber, 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 rubber.
You're saying things I like.
They have the Oloroso and the Sauternes, man. Oloroso, buddy. I'm biased, man. You can't ask me between Oloroso and Sauternes because the Oloroso to me is that. Oloroso to me is kind of rubbery, sulfuric anyway. So pair that with the intense rubber, the Belichin, man, you got a fucking winner. I'm telling you, bitter bomb. It's delicious. It's Rubber City. The Sauternes is a little sweeter, which pairs quite nice with that style of peat as well. Can't go wrong, dude. The port, if you can find the port, man. Holy fuck. Dude.
I kind of want to look back and see which one it was we did.
13 and 14 red wine cask is amazing as well, man. Oh, so, shit. Should I look?
You keep talking and I'll take a quick little peeky poo.
On here?
Oh.
On here?
Yeah, I don't have to leave anything. Oh. You keep talking to the camera. This will just disappear for a second.
So I'm going to keep talking to the camera.
You do that.
Ty's doing some research. And yeah, you must at some point do yourself the favor and try that that Ecuador. Yeah. That looks like a straight up Ecuador. That doesn't look like a Belichin.
Pause it real quick.
Yeah, that's regular Outdoor.
Oh, okay, well, that's the one we had.
Yeah, so that's still very intense, bright, abrasive, youthful, yummy, delicious whiskey. But the Belichin is heavy, tar rubber, tar life for me, man.
There's a signature Belichin 11-year Manzanilla sherry butt.
Those are all kinds of words I like.
I haven't had either one of those. I haven't had Signatory. I'm talking about the Outdoor bottle or the Belichin. Dude, again, if you like that pungent, heavy style of peat, man, Rubber City, buddy, I'm telling you. And let me know right away, man. I can't wait to hear your thoughts. Yeah, I fucking love Belichin.
Yeah?
Yeah. The cask strength Belichin in the boxes.
Yeah, so then only the cask strength comes in boxes?
Straight from the cask series, yeah, from Outdoor and Belichin, which is Outdoor's peated.
Oh, it's starting to split.
Yeah.
You're going to get that on these big inch jobs.
Oh, for sure.
It's a pipeliner joke. Sorry about that. Love that shit, tar and rubber.
If you love tar and rubber, and that's straight from the cask, if it's the straight from the cask Belichin in the box and it's cask strength, dude, it's a smaller bottle, but you cannot go wrong.
I'm just looking back here, and Derek's talking about the Glenmorangie Astaire, and he says cocoa powder, caramel, and vanilla cream. How would that compare to the Tale of Cake?
Not even remotely similar.
Like, he's describing dessert whiskey again.
Yeah, but it's a musty kind of dessert.
Okay.
Yeah, it's like an oaky sweetness.
Because that cake,
the cake is pineapple cake sweetness.
Mm.
Yeah, it's completely different altogether.
Where does Clayton live?
BC.
Oh, little hunting spot, eh? You found a special hunting dusty spot? It was all in the nose. Palate was one apple.
Okay.
Okay, okay. Feel you, feel you. Well, Clayton, if you happen to be going back to that store, if it's in your
home. I got the list. I'll show you the list.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Never mind that. This just goes out to everybody. If you happen to find a little hole-in-the-wall liquor store and you see things you've never heard of, you know what it is, take a picture, DM either one of us, and if it's not something you want, it might be something we want, and we'll make it worth your while. Help us hunt.
Yeah.
Become
We'll even crack it and send you a bottle, right?
Help us become one of your Scotch snipers. You become part of the tribe. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Cast strength, 109 US. So that's like 300 Canadian.
That's a going rate for those straight from the cast stuff anyway. But yeah, Clayton, there was a couple there, like the Brookladdie Lynx, which were very cool after golf courses and stuff. I don't fuck with Brookladdie, man. I don't touch Brookladdie anymore. No.
But I might, because I'm looking for some golfing whiskey. All I've found so far is that, what is that, Old St. Andrew's Clubhouse or whatever the fuck. But I'm, looking for more golf-inspired whiskeys. And if anybody out there happens to find Cooper's baseball whiskey, the one that came in the baseball size, not the minis, but the full-size baseball Cooper's American whiskey. Please let me know. Cooperstown, Coopers. Yeah. Yeah. All 10 of you that are still here. Why no more Brookladdie? Why don't you like Brookladdie anymore, Josh? Did you have a bad experience or you just had so much of it?
I like Brookladdie a lot, and I collected Brookladdie for a while. And several rare and lovely Brookladdies burned in 2016. And I just didn't have the heart to replace them. And trying to replace them would have been extremely costly. So
trying
I
to source them out.
I just stopped. I didn't buy any Brookladdie unless I seen one on a dusty shelf. That's where I found that wine cast finish. And that's where I found the one I have downstairs now. The only Brookladdie except Octomore. Of course,
I'll drink Octomore all day. One that I convinced
that's
you
OBA.
Not to get rid of.
That's the 1989.
Yeah. Still here? Is it gone?
It's here.
So I owe you money for that.
Well, it's ours. It's at the headquarters. We'll open it and drink it. I'd rather drink it. Yeah, there'll be no exchange of money. We'll just drink it on a show. I think we should probably review that one.
We should. Yeah, Derek, if you're not aware, our city burned down. It was a large event. did a couple of news interviews. You can Google my name if you give a fuck. But yeah, Josh lost his house, the headquarters burned, and he lost a ton of irreplaceable bottles. It's very sad. So it's not that he doesn't fuck with Brooke Laddie anymore because he doesn't like it.
It's three bottles in my house.
It hurts. That's a reminder.
Yeah. The OBA, the X4, and a 1989 Brooke Laddie. And that's it. Every other Brooke Laddie I have opened and drank.
Yeah.
I do not stock them. I do not collect them anymore.
I'm almost done, Josh.
Yep.
It's so sad.
That's the last one, too, man. That's it. That's all she wrote. I mean, there's one backup, but.
Yeah, but that's it.
That's it.
Put that off to the side. Jump back into.
I've been pouring this one like four or five times. How's our battery?
We're going to have to plug it in. I'm going to have to go grab the plug. I thought we could survive without it. We didn't have a place to plug in. I might use that extension cord. We'll be all right. I should probably go.
Yeah, they had the Octomore 4.1 there at this hole in the wall that Clayton found, which is shocking to me. That's years and years and years ago. I might actually want one of those, depending on the price. We'll take it offline. But if you could have found the Comus, I think the Comus was 4.2. Top-notch Octomore. Orpheus is probably my favorite. That was maybe 2.2 or something like that. Yeah. That one was good. I like that OBA a lot as well. But that Comus, that was something else. And I don't recall the 4.1. So. Has anyone had the 4.1? Does anyone know? What's your favorite Octomore? Anybody? And if you're viewing this later, put it in the comments. I'm very curious to know what your favorite Octomore is and why. Mine is the OBA, just because of the whole beautiful bottle and the beautiful tube that it's in, and the whiskey inside is so dark and young and lovely. It's actually, it's quite nice. 10.1. Nick, you've had the 8.1. One of my favorites was the 8.3, actually. And yeah, I'm a fan of Octomore. That heavy abrasive kind of peat. I enjoy that.
The other end of this?
Oh. Probably plugged in to the
stove. No, I got the plug.
Ty's having a struggle, but yeah. It's for the greater good. Yeah, man. You know what? You're going to make this work, Ty.
I'm going to make this fucking difficult. It's going to be
difficult. They had a weird Glenallachie. Chinquapin wood. What the fuck is that?
Let me look this shit up.
Did that work, Josh?
Yep.
Okay.
What is that? I'm looking it up. CH. Here it is. This looks like something I haven't tried. Okay, interesting. And virgin oak. Yeah, so I'm not familiar with this one. Bottled at 48%. And Glenallachie, of course, natural color, not chill filter.
Oh, those are two of my favorite things.
Yep. Okay, American wood. Interesting. Nick, Mr. Master Chef, which one they have at Whiskey Drop? The Glenallachie or the Hazelburn?
Hazelburn.
Oh, Hazelwood. Octomore, I see. I think I might do another purge on this.
I was going to say, I could use that lighter just to touch this up. I really regret not bringing my lighter out.
Ah, the Glenallachie. Okay, cool. Yeah, I haven't had that one. Let me try another purge.
I got to say, Tam, if you're still here, thanks, man. This one worked out. Real nice. And if it was that Spanish cedar that kind of gave it that initial sweetness, I'm a fan, and it makes me want to get some Spanish cedar to start aging some cigars in. I got a bunch of ammo boxes left over that I could line and throw some in. That could be interesting.
My humidor Spanish cedar line.
That probably helped it too then.
Kilcloman. Winter.
Winter.
Oh, Ben the Demon Hunter has joined us. Hey, buddy.
Hi, Ben.
Yeah, I'm not familiar with Kilcloman. Well, I mean, I'm familiar with Kilcloman, but I don't know the ins and outs of it. Sean is your man for that, by the way.
Yeah. Master Kincaid himself.
Ben says Josh. Josh says Ben.
Ty says Red Rover, Red Rover.
Box press.
Hi, Ben. I need want that shirt.
This was a gift. Unless you're talking about.
No, he's talking about you because he said Josh first.
Yeah, we're Pete. We're doing the Pete thing. Love the Pete. Hashtag. Yeah, it was a gift from a good friend, Paul. He said, I know you love Pete. And I said, yes, I do.
These are facts.
He said, I know you wear shirts. I said, I do.
Occasionally. Not always, though.
Mostly.
There's been evidence on the internet that you don't.
True. Drafty in here. Yeah. So I figured I'd plug the Scotch Test Dummies. Because why not?
When you're done watching them, make sure you watch us.
Yeah, after you're going to learn from the Scotch Test Dummies, come and watch the Whiskey Heathen Dummies.
Yeah, and if you get it in your head, ACAB, then come over here. Yeah.
This is still good. It's very oily now, but it's also very dusty.
Mine started to crack quite a bit.
Okay.
The whole wrapper is cracking, but it's not bad. Mm. It hasn't affected the flavor.
So yeah, my wrapper is good to go. And as you see, it has very much even note.
Ben, what you did miss, not only were we drinking that Laphroaig of fine cigars pleasure, we did a bottle kill tonight of the Carchus. Their port and red wine finish. And it's one of my favorites.
Yep. Peter Whiskey of the Year. 2020 for me. It's very, very good.
That's the end of it.
That's it, man. That's all she wrote.
Saving that for the very end of the show, then.
That's a gooder.
Yeah, it is.
It's going to be easy to miss that one.
A fun episode to do too.
Yeah. So there it is.
Cool. It's not an awkward silence. No. It's not awkward for us.
That's right.
Maybe you guys thought your screens froze.
Maybe we've ran out of things to say.
Well, that's not likely. Need more port. Only had a Quinta Ruben 12. Very much wanted. I thought the Quinta Ruben was 14, or is there two?
The 12 was replaced by the 14.
I do like that 14.
That 14 though. Is fucking ridiculous.
Oh, man. The green one we're talking about, right?
Yeah. I seen it on sale. It wanted me off for $72.
Like on your last trip?
Yeah.
I have one left.
That's very good. I can't even buy it. 3 days. Gone. Yeah. It's quite nice. I like it.
Yeah.
And if you get the really old stuff, it's a different color. So that's cool. They started adding color to it.
Oh, that's a shame.
Well, yeah, people were bringing it back thinking there was something wrong with it.
Like, these people are stupid.
Well, you know.
Excuse me, this bottle doesn't live up to the color expectations. It tastes great, but I don't like the way it looks.
Balvenie 21.
Saw a thing today, the Balvenie Caribbean cask. Marked down to $7.99, a $78 savings because they just wanted to get it the fuck off the shelves.
Yep. Now, at $7, would I buy a case? Yes.
Yeah, yeah. I'll buy anything decent for $8 a bottle. US, but still.
But at the price they charge?
Well, that was American prices. So it would be like $130, $140 here. Any 14 Caribbean. Oh. Yes, but oh, you're a fan. Well then,
yeah,
head to the States where it's $8 a bottle right now.
Ben, it's too light for me, man. It's too sweet. It's fucking rum cask.
There it is. Josh does not like minus two that we know of rum cask finished whiskeys. You like the Glenlivet from Old Malt Cask, ironically enough, tonight.
Yeah.
And we had one recently, Springbank.
Oh yeah. I didn't like it at first at all. And I voiced my opinion on Springbank, gone downhill. But now I have like this much left. And I'm like, yummy. It's kind of growing on me.
I like that Glenfiddich Fire and Cane. Okay, so that's a little different. That was their experiment series. They did something with it. I also enjoy the Glenfiddich
Fire and Cane. I also enjoy
the Glenfiddich. So there's three rum cask finish you like.
Yep. That's true.
Yeah. One of my friends, he liked it enough that he keeps it stocked. He bought two cases of it. I still have like maybe a heel left in a bottle.
I kill mine quick.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm thinking of throwing that into my peated infinity bottle.
Are you doing an infinity bottle?
I'm doing
or
three.
Are you doing a home blend? Because an infinity bottle means
it's constantly getting drank and refilled.
It goes forever.
Yeah.
It's infinity.
Yeah.
A home blend means you add 30 whiskeys and you stop and you drink it.
No, I'm doing an infinity bottle. Interesting. We'll just continue.
Are you going to keep a running list of what's in it?
Nah.
I think you should.
Why?
Because at the end of the day, you might have 600 whiskeys in that. You know what I mean? If it's an infinity bottle.
Should I be shaking it up as I go? Like,
yeah, you put that in there. Give it a shake and a shake, man. Because then forever. You always have a minuscule amount of everything you've drank.
Maybe I'll throw a whiteboard up in the office and just keep adding to it.
Even if it's on a note, man.
Yeah.
As long as it's there, right? Because I don't do that. I don't have time for that. I don't have room for fucking bottles just kicking around.
No, you don't.
Right? So there was a time where I would play around with that. And then I turned it into a home blend. So I had a very specific list of whiskeys at a very specific proportion, and I sampled it out.
Yeah, I remember. It was good. I liked it. Ben, you can skip the 20. It's okay. You know, you could definitely skip the IPA. That I thought was...
IPA is shite.
Yeah, I was going to say
the garbage. The 20 I liked when it's on sale.
Wasn't one of those 20 Canadian pick as well?
Yeah, like that. She picked a port cask. There's one pork cask in there. I liked it. And if it's on sale for a really good price is when you should buy it. I would never pay full price for that. The Winter Storm, there's not a chance in hell I'm paying $300 for the likes of that. The Fire and Cane, I think, was the one that really shone in that series.
Absolutely. Absolutely agree. I do like it when we agree on certain whiskeys, and that's one of them. And I don't have much left, and I think that's worth picking up another bottle.
Which one?
The firing cane. Like I got like, I want to say like an eighth of the bottle. I got about that much left.
About this much for those of you watching.
Yeah, there you go. What would you call that, Nate?
Heel.
Heel. Yeah.
Got a heel.
Four fingers, maybe. Fire and Cane is fantastic in a whiskey sour with egg whites. I could see that, actually.
I'll give it a go.
I do enjoy a good whiskey sour.
I've seen fire and I've seen cane.
No more singing. God damn it. I'm trying to stop myself. Better hurry. Fire and Cane discontinued. Yeah, there's lots of beer, though.
They're all discontinued, aren't they?
Yeah, their experiment series is done with. But there's still lots.
Yeah.
It's kicking lots around. Here. Yeah,
there's no shortage.
Fort McMurray. Not enough people buy it, I guess. So.
There is no shortage of that here. Yeah.
I think every Wine and Beyond I've ever been to, it's still there. Yeah.
So goes on sale, too, right? If it's Wine and Beyond Liquor Depot and stuff, it goes on sale.
Yeah, they're not numbering their bottles or anything. For an experiment series, they certainly put out a bunch of an experiment.
Tam says they want to go back to a luxury brand.
Good luck.
Good fucking luck is right.
We will have our
Glenlivet
episodes come in soon.
I'd like to see him revamp their core range, man. Like instead of a 12-year-old, give us a fucking 10-year-old. Give us a good 10-year-old.
They don't consider anything less than 12 luxury.
Ugh.
Yeah.
13 then. Fuck it. Go to a weird number. Right? Instead of the 15, give us a 17. Instead of 21. Give us a 22, man, or when a 19.
When you're this far into the game, though, can Glenfiddich turn around and become a luxury brand? Like, they were at a point, and it dipped off, and it just became the whiskey that's everywhere.
Well, look at the 12. That's not a luxury brand.
That's what I mean. That's not a luxury. It's in every single. That's bar rail scotch at this point.
Yeah.
So how do you – man, you'd have to do quite a marketing campaign.
Yeah.
To turn that around to become Glenfiddich as
well,
what I think luxury.
Look what McKellen did. Okay. They built a reputation making amazing whiskey. They used to add, what is it, Paxerat or whatever, the sherry stuff they used to add, which was delicious. I've had whiskeys bottled in the 60s from McKellen. That's delicious. It's beyond, it's peerless. And then they were like, let's release a whole bunch of random horse piss and we'll call it Random Things. And we'll charge luxury prices, and we're already a luxury brand. People are gonna fucking love it.
And they did.
And they still do. And nerds like us are like, fuck you, man.
Just hire the marketing team from Callan.
Right?
Glenfiddich has a 22 grand Cortez. Yeah, no, I'm not saying they don't have great stuff. What I'm saying is it's like you can't turn around and be. If nobody knows fuck all about scotch and you say, hey, name me three scotch brands, they're going to say Glenfiddich because it is a common household name, because it's at every bar, every hotel bar, every restaurant you go to. It's one of the top ones on the menu. It's a go-to bar rail scotch. So to turn around from that and be like, oh, yeah, we're actually a luxury brand. You can put out big names and people that don't know any better that are going to go buy a gift for someone, graduation or a father-in-law or something that they don't know much about. They're going to go, well, Glenfiddich, everybody knows Glenfiddich. It must be the best. Yep. So you're not really trading in, like when it comes to nerds like us and everybody here, right? Yeah. I don't consider them a luxury brand.
Bonnehaven is in a very interesting transition now. For those of you who've been around a while, you knew Bonnehaven is not always that popular, and it's exploding. And we can't pretend it's not, in some aspects, help from Mike, the Whiskey Explorer on Instagram. He's pushing his product, and he's doing well.
He's a fantastic brand ambassador.
He is, man. And he got us hooked, right? We got on the Bonnehaven train, maybe just a little bit before Mike came on the scene, but Mike was so friendly and personable that he made you want to drink one of them more.
Private hotel parties.
Yeah, so we did. And now Bonahavn is starting to climb in price. It's starting to climb in being rare.
Still got the 12 for like $60-something.
Yeah, yeah. But
it's good.
That's their core range. It's above 40%. Like, it's good whiskey. It's tasty whiskey. But there's going to be a time when Bonahavn is the luxury brand that we can't afford anymore. Right? And it's going that way. And it's because it's popular and it's delicious, it's consistent, it's reliable. So, like,
you know. It's just weird. You know what I mean? Try to tout yourself as a luxury brand. It's like Mazda trying to pretend to be Mercedes. Now, Mazda's put out some beautiful interiors on their cars. You could look at the interior of a Mazda, and if you didn't know any better, go, fuck, that might be a BMW. Like, you don't know, right? But you don't go, oh, Mazda, yes, the luxury car brand is what it is, exactly. So it's really hard to reinvent yourself like that, especially in today's age. Yeah. And I just don't see it. I don't think I'm ever going to be like, oh, yes, Glenfiddich, the cream of the crop.
Got to go get me a Glenfiddich.
Yeah.
I said, we're in a very interesting time right now because we're in a whiskey boom. And we get to see kind of a fall of the mighty. Oh, how the great have fallen, man. Like, McKellen is on a downward trend. I mean, their sales are probably up, but they're pushing whiskey to the masses. Mass whiskey, triple cast, this, 15, 18. Like,
well, you know what it is.
Oh, my God. The old 12-year-old at 43%, bomb-ass shit. The Ruby, completely delicious, man. You know, the 18s, the old 18s are really good. The new 18s are good too, but it's $450.
That's what I mean.
For an 18-year-old McKellen. So we're starting to see that people are catching on. But no, they're also catching on to the good stuff that's inexpensive now. We're watching that rise too. So it's very weird. It's a weird time right now for whiskey.
It's a great time for whiskey. What's happening, and it's happening in a lot of different aspects. I could bring it back to our earlier conversation about this GameStop stonks type situation going on, right? Is it's the old heads, the your grandfather's whiskey. Oh, only grandpa drinks scotch. We're in our 30s. You know what I mean? Like, there are kids younger than us that are getting into this shit. And it's whiskey is it's not your grandpa's whiskey anymore. It's no longer the old brands that are, you know, leading the forefront. It's the newer stuff. It's the craft beer. It's the craft hot sauce. It's the craft whiskeys that are really making a name for themselves. And we have such access to wonderful communication tools like this channel, for one, where you can get more information and find out whiskeys you've never heard of that would never look at because it's just, you know, it's bottom of the shelf. You never noticed it. You don't recognize the name, so you don't buy it. Now you're hearing it. You're hearing that name in the inner circles, and it's getting out to the more mainstream, and it's becoming craft whiskey. It's the same type thing. So to take an old name like Glenfiddich and then just be like, yeah, we're a luxury brand now.
It would have to be major.
Yeah, they got to do something interesting.
A major, major revamp. McKellen Edition 3 on a website for $2,000. Get off that website, son.
Yeah.
They were $160. Even recently, you could get them for $200.
Like Jasper Liquor that tried to charge $400 for Alberta Premium. Are you on that website?
Yeah, that's brutal. That Edition 2 was $154. That was really good. It used to go on sale. Everything goes on sale at on Liquor Depot.
Eventually.
So, like, for Christmas and stuff, you'd see it.
Just keep your eyes open. Visit $30
off, you know?
You know, you can walk into a store.
So it was $124. And we were like, fuck yes, man.
You have the ability to walk into a store, look at the shelves, and not buy anything. You should do that regularly.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see what's moving. And start recognizing things and be like, oh, hey, it's on sale. Then wanted to pick that up, but that price point wasn't good for me. Now it is.
Mm-hmm.
Visit weekly. Support your local liquor store.
I'm all about sales, man. You know, some places I'll go and they give me a heathen's discount.
Yeah, we've been lucky enough that when we roll into places, they usually give us 15, 10, 15, 20%.
I mean, like, we'll take it, man. There's a $100 bottle, you say 10, 15 bucks, man. Why not?
Reminds me, I'm going to talk about something. You've known this for a while. It was new to me. Internet scams when it comes to bourbon and whiskey. So
don't trust anyone.
Yeah. So I like fucking with them. I lead them along for a while. And I was fucking with one today. They'll post other people's pictures and like a bunch of pictures within the last like 3 days. And this one was called Liquor Pour 3. Another one was some stupid fucking name, Frank Liquor 705 or some shit like that, right? And they'll be on Instagram and they'll have tons of bottles of Blanton's and Pappy and Stag Junior. And it's like, just in time for Valentine's Day, special deal, free shipping. And you're like, okay. You follow 9,000 people and 140 people follow you. So I fuck with them. I message them. I'm like, oh, how much for two bottles of the Pappy 25? And they'll get back to me like, I only got the 12. It's $850 a bottle. And I'm like, oh, cool. Okay, cool. Well, the one today, I just kept hearting every message he sent me until he was like, so are we going to do this or not? But their English is always terrible. So what I'm saying is things aren't on sale at a store and you're really looking for it. And suddenly it's on Instagram. You're like, ooh, Blanton's Gold, $110. Free shipping if I buy two? Fuck yeah. Well, I'll just send it to this random guy that's only been on Instagram for 2 days. That sounds good. The only reason these accounts continue to exist is because people are falling for it.
Yep.
They wouldn't do it if it wasn't profitable. So if you ever see some of those, just watch out.
Yeah.
They're not a secondary market. They're just a flat out fucking scam. So, yeah. Just something, a little warning I wanted to give to people. I like fucking with scammers. It's been a passion of mine for many years. If you follow me on Instagram or Facebook, you can see usually screenshot all the fun I have with them.
Yep.
It's really good. It's a lot of enjoyment and time. And sometimes I got a lot of time on my hands riding the bus back and forth. So just be careful of these idiots. That's all. It sounds too good to be true. It's because it's not.
I'm done.
You are a quick smoker. I still got a bit to go, but this wrapper has crapped out. But that was a wonderful cigar.
Yep.
I would like more of those.
I agree. That was really nice.
I dabble in the secondary. Been scoring some awesome bottles. Again, I'm not discouraging that. I get that. I'm just saying these scammers that, oh, yeah, I got a warehouse full. I can get you a whole pallet. I posted one of those the other day, too. That was fun.
Get your whole pallet.
A whole pallet of Pappy. Let's do it. Yeah, I have just a touch left at this.
Yeah, I'm almost out here too. It's my last one, I do believe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got a sip left. I'm gonna end the show with that shortly. Yep. Yeah. Well, man, we've gone through quite a bit of shit today. Yeah.
Good conversation.
I've missed doing these lives. They're always fun.
Me too. So much easier now.
Yeah. You know, always look for the rare bourbon. It's not sure why. I'm not a huge fan of bourbon. So like Stag Junior, the Pappy, Eagle, extra rare, really rare, whatever the fuck they call it with the glass top. Yeah, just a bunch of bullshit. I get it. You want to try something that's in high demand and allocations are limited. Like, I get it. But the Eagle Rare, here's a good example. Saw it in a store. We've been talking about it for a while. You never said anything about it because, you know, that's how you learn. I finally found a bottle. I bought it. We did an episode on it. I opened it up. You can watch the episode to find out a bit more. But,
meh.
I don't know what the fucking hype was about. That's all it comes down to. I don't know why everyone's like, ooh, Eagle Rare. Yay. I don't get it.
I don't get it. A lot of love for that Buffalo Trace too, man.
Yeah, that I really don't get.
Whew.
Someone messaged me like, man, you shitting on my buff? I'm like, yeah, we are. It's not terrible. I don't get the hype.
I didn't like it. I was like, no thanks. Stagg Jr. I like Stagg Jr. Yeah.
So I've not had Stagg Jr. and I've been on the lookout, and I highly doubt I'm ever going to find it here. Maybe one day.
I used to get it in Grand Prairie all the time.
That's what I mean. I don't go to Grand Prairie. So
it's back before it was big hype, though.
So yeah, something just catches and explodes, and everybody wants it. Hopefully that happens to this channel soon enough. You guys can help out by commenting on our videos, liking and subscribing, and sharing with some of your friends. When someone says, oh yeah, I like whiskey, like, do you guys know about the Whiskey Heathens? And then you can bust out your phone and show them briefly. Better yet, take their phone, go to the channel, and hit subscribe for them so that they know what's up. Shameless plug, I don't care. We need the views, we need the subscribers, so that we can use our monetary funds from YouTube to buy more booze and share it with all of you.
That's the end game here. Actually, that's the mid game. The end game is death.
But yeah.
The mid game is where it's at.
And we'll get there eventually. Not from drinking, because we really don't do enough of that.
Ben says, people love the shit on the Ardbeg Black. I fucking loved it.
Yeah. We did a whole series, 3 videos.
Yeah. Check out our videos if you like. We did the Black, the committee release, and then we did them both side by side. And I have since changed my opinion, but you'll have to check it out.
YOLO, am I right? Oh, man. You only liver once. Yep, you only get one liver. I have 3. My brother gave me one of his. He didn't need to. I just wanted it. So extra drinking power.
It's like I'm Shameless, man. New liver, good to go.
Cool. Yep, would rather have scotch, specifically peat. Bourbon market's crazy stupid, mostly because of people getting their stimulus checks. I guess... Yeah. I heard through the grapevine, my American friends, that they weren't sending out checks. The new COVID stimulus package were sending out essentially prepaid credit cards. But enough people have received the bullshit ones from like Chase and City Financial and all that, that they just opened it up. Oh, another fake fucking bullshit credit card, and threw it out. Apparently there's like fucking millions of dollars of prepaid credit cards that just won't get used because people got them in the mail, go, that's fucking fake, and threw it out.
Oh,
dear. Oh, man. Yeah. Is Canada paying people's salaries? Fuck no, they're not.
They were paying my salary.
They were doing CERB, which was, I think, roughly $2,000 a month Canadian, so like $80 American, but not enough. So, no, they are not paying our salaries. They couldn't afford our salaries.
We're an oil country, man. It's a little bit different here.
Yeah, a little different here in the frozen tundra of the north.
Yep.
Literally on secondary, lots of bottles skyrocketing in price. Bottles of E.H. Taylor 4G pushing 1,800. Sipping on the Forager Botanical. Yeah, it's okay. And the bottles of Four Roses hitting 400.
Wow, really? I still got that Four Roses you got for me. Man, that weird one, the Perfect 10.
Giving out 2 stimulus here. Yeah, didn't you guys get like 1,200 one time and now 600 again or something like that in like a year?
Yeah, I'm going to get hit on tax time.
Oh, no, I'm getting.
I'm done my last little sip here, everybody.
We're going to wrap this up here in about, we have 15 minutes. We'll hit the 2-hour mark. That'll be it.
Well, I'm going to pour it on.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? My cigar is done, though.
How does Alberta get such great deals in variety of bottles compared to other provinces? Well, one, Ontario, my home province, corrupt as all hell. They have a government-sanctioned liquor store. So they claim that the benefit is they have buying power, and they are. They set records here this year with COVID. They are able to purchase a lot. However, they don't pass on the savings because what you have is, if you're cashier, it's a government employee. So they've opened it up that you can buy beer and wine in grocery stores, but hard liquor you must purchase from the LCBO, the Liquor Control Board of Ontario. Now, They don't bring in anything that won't sell because they use that money for healthcare and whatnot, right? But they don't really give a fuck about the consumer. They're just going to bring in what will move quickly and bring in money. So they don't bring in a lot of cool one-offs, independent bottlers very often. And when they do, they get enough people that know before it even hits the shelves, it's snatched up. They do a lottery system. Alberta, on the other hand, has independent stores. Now, it's still governed by the province, but individual stores can dictate their prices. Whereas Ontario, if it costs $80 in Toronto, it costs $80 in St. Catharines, and it costs $80 in Thunder Bay. So the whole province, the price is the same.
Balvenie 17 double wood, $300.
It's only like 120 here.
Well, now it's like over 200 here, but it used to be 170 like a couple years ago, man.
So other provinces too. Saskatchewan is weird. They have government and private.
OMC is a quality bottler, generally speaking.
Yes. Everyone I've had from them, I've enjoyed. And we discussed earlier, you might have missed it, Clayton. Not always at 50% like we thought.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, there's my rant on why I hate the Ontario liquor system and why I love Alberta. Quick story. The moment I learned I loved Alberta, the province, was my first year here. Online, I purchased a new rifle, a 270 Savage Axis. And I told the guy, I'm in Fort Mac. I'll be driving to Edmonton after work. I won't be there till midnight. Is that going to be a problem? And he said no. So I showed up at his doorstep at midnight. Never went in the house. He brought the gun out to me. And on the porch, I checked the rifle, cleared it, was happy with it. Counted out the cash and said, hey, I got to go get some beer. It was midnight on a Tuesday, and I was able to go buy a six-pack after just buying a rifle. And that's when I realized that I'm in the freest province in this country, and I love Alberta, and I'm never going back to Ontario. You can buy booze and guns at midnight on a Tuesday. That's all I needed to know. What's the nickname for LCBO? I don't know.
The Ontario Liquor Mafia or whatever?
Probably.
Yeah, I don't know. Is that a joke? I don't know.
Thanks for clarifying. Seems like Alberta is like California minus the lax gun laws. Our gun laws are nationwide. All of our gun laws in Canada are the same throughout every province. It's very difficult to get a license here. There is a criminal background check done every 24 hours. If you're arrested, your license is automatically revoked, pending trial, and so on and so forth. KGBO. I didn't know that. Yeah, I do. I didn't know that, but I like it. That's good. KGBO. Nice. My ex-girlfriend works for them. She's an ex for a reason. She's not watching. All of Canada is like California, not Alberta. Eh. They consider Alberta to be the Texas of Canada, mainly because of oil, but...
Also because you can buy a rifle at midnight and go pick up a six-pack.
Yeah, yeah.
Although back home, well, I guess here too, but growing up's like the bar's closing and it's last call. So you have like
off sales
hours, right? Because they'll stay open for you. And it's like, Pauline, can you give me a ride home? And she's like, of course.
That's the other thing.
Take so you down the road. Good to go.
Ontario bars, last call is at 2. All alcohol must be off the table by 2:45 and the bar is closed at 3. Alberta, last call is at 2. You can buy off sales. I'm like, that's cool. Can I get a bottle and a six pack to go? And they're like, yep, here you go. That's freedom, baby. It's stupid. It's stupid to say that that's freedom, but unfortunately, that's the definition right now. Oil, farming, capital cities, both progressive. Yeah, it's true. It's true. Our major cities are quite liberal. It's not a bad thing. It just is what it is. But yeah, we're our province is kind of hurting right now with the Biden presidential win, only because he canceled Keystone XL. Doesn't super affect us It does affect all my pipeliner friends. I've been out of the pipeline game for a while, so it doesn't really affect me. I got other jobs. In extreme weather, that's right. Today's not bad. What did you say it was? Minus 17?
It was minus 13.
Minus 13.
It was minus 41 on our shop thermometer a couple days ago, last week. Yep.
Yeah, that's cold.
Minus 41, man. We were out in a Zoom Boom.
Whoa.
And the open cab forklift.
I'm going to peel this wrapper off as well at this point. Oh, yeah, it's thin tissue paper. Oh, yeah. Still good, though. Well, we got 10 minutes left, folks. Fuck you want to talk about?
Yeah.
Fuck, I thought.
Paul, look, I'm wearing a shirt you gave me, Paul. Where you the peach?
Where you been for the last 2 hours?
We're drinking peat, Paul.
The Dusty Shop, they had OMC LaFroy 12, 13, 15, 8. Where is this magical store he found? Tell me later.
Yeah, show you
later. Fishermen don't like to give away their fishing holes. Hunters don't like to give away their hunting spots. And Scotch snipers don't like to give away their Scotch hides. I get it. Thank you.
Bit of Irish peat. Oh, Connemara. Is that the one?
I don't remember. I'm not an Irish fan, remember?
I can't remember either.
What's your favorite cask maturation?
Oloroso!
Yeah, it was this year for sure, last year.
What about you? We started off liking it a little sweeter, like a Sauternes cask and stuff like that.
A PX, maybe.
Yeah, now you're like leaning towards peat.
Yeah, now I'm really liking peat. It's come around. Yeah, Cormaris, but good job. Called Black. What is it? Black Pits or some shit.
I don't know.
Peated Teeling. Yeah, so Derek, you don't know. I haven't found an Irish whiskey I like yet. We are waiting. Josh has a bottle. He thinks it'll change my mind. There's something about the way the Irish distill that just turns me off. I don't know what it is.
Yeah. I got one I think, will change his mind. Yep.
Yeah. So we'll get there. Once we film the episode, we'll end up going live after it's aired and we'll talk about it. But we love that you join us for our lives, but we need you to watch our episodes. Give them thumbs up, some nice comments, if you will, and share with friends. That's what we need. How is the Glenmorangie Nectar d'Or?
Sweet. The nose is the star of that one. You could nose that all day long. Yeah?
Is it a cologne whiskey again? Put on the backs of our ears.
Well, it's typical Glenmorangie style, so it's very light and pleasant. And it's a standard, reliable bottle. Yeah.
Mandisa. Is that my friend Mandisa?
Well, you know.
Do you know another Mandisa?
No.
It might be my friend Mandisa. Hi. Just put the baby to bed. Yeah, you're late. We're leaving in 5 minutes. That's all good. Thanks for joining.
Glenmorangie has a peat at one, yeah.
You missed our lovely talk about R. Kelly.
Ah, shit.
Does Glenmo have
What's any that Glenmorangie peat, man? Shit.
It'll come to him.
Alta?
I don't remember either.
I gotta
consult the Oracle. Check the Google machine. Yeah,
I'm pretty sure.
Ba, 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 ba. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm going to have to convince Tam to perhaps pick us up a few more of these because this was nice.
Fenalta.
Sweet. Fenalta.
What did I say?
Glenmoran. You said Alta.
Ah, so pretty cool. Fenalta. Fenalta.
You missed a few letters. No big deal.
Yeah, very good.
I think Alta is the new Astaire, a star.
Could be.
Fred Astaire, a star. throwing out old references today.
Yeah, this one's good. I like that one. Had that a while ago now. Fuck. I thought it was Alta.
Idiot.
Never heard of the Finalta.
Me neither, Derek. Nice,
don't feel bad.
Nice, like, grayish kind of label. Beautiful bottle.
Never seen it. Oh. Will I ever see it?
No.
No. Says God. Yeah. When it comes to knowing your whiskey, you have to consult Know Your Whiskey. Let's see. Nope. Never seen it. Never heard of it. Auctions.
Yeah, that's what I remember. The gray up top with that nice blue top there.
Is that worth getting on auction for us?
No.
Nah. Oh, well, there you go. That's all you need to know. It's not worth our time.
It's good, but I'm not going to rush out and buy a bottle. And I don't want to say it, but there's Glenburgie out there to buy.
That's true. Yeah. Don't give away the secret. People will be snatching them up before we get our hands on them all.
There's McKellen to buy.
Yeah, there's a bunch of Glenfiddich.
Yeah, go yourself some Glenfiddich on auction.
If you caught that, guys, you're lucky. You you just got some insider trading facts on what the next big whiskey is going to be.
you've seen it here.
Yeah.
Paul, auction starts tomorrow. Excuse me. So I'm super excited to see what's on the dossier.
Well, I hope you win.
I usually win one or two each month.
Run for the Fiddick.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, go by that. Ignore what we said earlier a minute ago. Been thinking about some of the signatory bottles at the local liquor shop.
Which signatory, though?
Yeah. So, I mean, they've done multiple different distilleries, right?
Yeah, and they got multiple different lines, like the signature or whatever the fuck it's called. Then they have the cask strength limited stuff. Like, there's a whole bunch of different ones. Does the bottle have a big ass top?
And that's done.
We only got 3 minutes left.
Anyway. Yeah. That was good timing on that cigar, though. That Thanks again, Tam. Yeah,
Tam.
That was good, man. Appreciate you, bro.
I like that shit. So, I like that shit.
If you missed it, with the last 3 minutes here, we drank the old malt cask. I'll show the people here. The old malt cask, a fine cigar's pleasure, a Lafroy 10-year-old. You can see the episode. We filmed drinking this at the Q Cigar Room in Edmonton. And, man, what a night that was. It was just an enjoyable day all around. So we drank this tonight. And earlier tonight, not here on the live, but we killed a bottle of Lafroy Karchus.
Karchus.
Port and red wine cask finish, which is one of my top 10 whiskey releases of 2020. I loved it, and there, right there, is the very end of that bottle. I've been holding on to it, and with that,
yep, yummy. Cheers, everybody. Oh. Ben, it is good. It's a young, abrasive, but still kind of approachable 5-year-old. I liked it. But yeah, we're gonna sign off. We had a pretty good run, and we had a good conversation tonight. This a was bunch fun. Of people stuck with us for like 2 hours here.
Yeah, still 11 people here. We appreciate that. Thanks for tuning in, even if you didn't make it for the last 5 minutes, like my friend Mandisa. Thanks for popping in.
Paul just popped in, gave me the shirt, and Ben, we'll keep closing off here by furthering your discussion. You want a wee beastie first before a second 10. Ben, what I recommend when you're starting off your fairly early on your whiskey journey, don't buy a second bottle of anything.
No, buy new stuff.
Buy always a new bottle of something. And the worst case scenario, man, is you fucking learn a lesson not to buy that bottle again. Don't stick to what you know, man. Push those boundaries. I recommend that for me. That's what works for me best. And once I've tasted, you know, several dozens or whatever from that distillery,
you kind of get a signature feel for what they do. Yeah.
That's what I recommend, dude. Because
I do that with beer.
Ardbeg 10 is delicious. It is. And you know that. And you can pay to enjoy that again, or you can spend your hard-earned fucking dough on something completely different but still similar. And now you've broadened your palate. Right now you can redirect and recalibrate.
Absolutely.
That's what worked for me.
I do it for beer because it's cheaper. Whenever I hit the liquor store, I buy a ton of stuff I've never had before. But I always buy something that I have had before because I like to keep it stocked so that I know if I didn't like the first one, there's always something else that I know I enjoyed. Luckily, we've got wonderful, wonderful liquor cabinets full of all kinds of great things. And some not so great, but that's how you learn.
Yep. Some of the not so great ones are just as fun because they're so bad that you need to pour it for someone. Right?
Yeah.
I had an old port meal like that. It was so bad that I poured it for Dan and Nicole and a whole bunch of fucking people.
Did anybody like it?
Well, Nicole's like, leave it out for 2 days and it might be a little bit better. And it was. Mm-hmm. And everybody else is like, man, it's kind of weird. It's kind of off. It's kind of sour, but not in a good way. It was weird. So it was fun because we were all like, something's funky.
Yeah.
It's good. There's a bottle I bought in Jamaica at the airport. Pentland or
something. Like a travel exclusive type thing?
Yeah.
Bleh. I did a whiskey.
I wish I had more thumbs because I would give that whiskey 4 thumbs down.
Here you go, buddy. I'll give it to you for you. I did a lovely whiskey tasting over the holidays with friends, and I sent them a bunch of different samples, and then I included some swear jar. And I said, we're going to start with this so you guys know what shit tastes like.
Yeah.
And then everything after that was just going to be great.
Yeah. Interesting. So, that's a cool way to do
it. It was fun. I enjoyed it. Yeah. Anyway, that's going to be it for us. Yeah. I'm drinking water now. But cheers. Thanks for everyone that joined. Thanks to you, brother, again. Yeah. I miss doing these. Hopefully we'll catch some more Sundays over the next few months.
Yeah.
We right now we can't do it every week because, you know, schedules
don't always busy. Line up.
But be sure to subscribe to the channel. Share it with some friends. Please, let's help get those subscriber numbers up. We need them. Hit that like button on all the videos. Drop some comments. And, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for always joining us. We appreciate you. We'll catch you next time, everybody.
Love Pete.
Yeah. Dicks out for Harambe. Nothing to do with Pete. All right. See ya. Man, that's fun.